machine over here. I'm going to put in some olive oil. And I have some chopped potatoes over here that I've already chopped. So I'm going to put those in. Potatoes have to cook just for a little while before we put the meat in. Turn up the heat just a little bit. And in these potatoes, I'm going to put some salt so we can season the potatoes.
How much?
Oh, about 2 small handfuls of salt.
Handfuls?
Well, pinches.
There you go.
And some pepper.
What kind of pepper is that?
This is just black pepper that I'm grinding.
Okay.
I'm going to just stir these up. In the meantime, I have some garlic over here. And I'm going to crush these in a garlic crusher. This is my new toy. I just got it, so we'll see how it works. Wow, it works great.
Comes out in little noodles.
It comes out in little pieces of garlic.
Cool.
Yeah, so there we go. And it's like pasta. Add 4 cloves of garlic. You can use less garlic, but I love garlic, so I always use more than you might.
No, it's good for you too. It's good for
yes.
Good for your intestines.
It is good for you. I read one time that if garlic was a medicine, it would be too expensive for anybody to buy. So.
Really?
Yeah. It's good for your blood pressure and good antioxidant.
Yep. And in World War II, the Germans that were imprisoned in Russia used to use it for antibacterial for their wounds.
Out there needs garlic in them.
Yeah.
Might not smell very good, but keep the vampires away. Okay, these have been cooking for a little while longer. So here I've got some extra lean ground beef, and this is about 1 pound. And you can use any kind of ground beef. You can even use turkey if you want, ground turkey. Right in there. Get that broken up. I've got some spices over here. These are just a few of my favorite spices. This is seasoned salt, just to season the meat. Put a little bit on. And because we're going to have some chopped onions on top of these, I'm just going to use some dehydrated onions, just for flavor.
Let's see what kind of onions.
Maybe about 1 tablespoon or so. These are just minced onions and they're dehydrated. I've got some chipotle pepper. I'm just going to use a little bit of that, just a couple of dashes. Gotta have a little bit of cayenne pepper. Cayenne, how would you say it?
Cayenne.
Cayenne. And my favorite spice for any kind of Mexican dish is cumin. I always go heavy on the cumin.
I thought you said human. Human
yeah.
Spice.
Yeah, we're gonna do some cumin spice. I've got a cumin ground up in here. While your meat and all your stuff is cooking, let it cook for a little while, a little bit, and then put in your garlic. Sometimes your garlic will burn if you put it in right away. So I'm just going to brown that a little bit. Now I'm going to put my garlic in. a little while longer. Well, while this is cooking, you can go off and have a margarita or a glass of wine. Get ready for some good smothered burritos. Okay, we're back for the second part of this dish. I'm going to check on our meat here. It looks like it's browning and it's doing real good. It's almost done. Over here in this pan, we're going to make our sauce. So in the pan, I have melting, about a fourth cup of butter, maybe a little bit less. I'm going to make like a gravy out of this, and then we're going to add our cheese. Butter melt a little bit. When it's all melted, I'm going to take some flour and stir it in there. Make a nice gravy. So I hope everybody is hungry. This makes a big smothered burrito.
I'm hungry.
I know you are.
It does make a big one.
My husband's always up for a smothered burrito.
Definitely.
I wound up taking a little bit of that butter out. We wound up with about an eighth of a cup instead of a fourth of a cup because it was a little too much. So in this butter, I'm going to put in some just regular white flour, maybe about a fourth cup of flour. I'm going to just stir it up and make our base for our gravy. And I need to get past you for just a second. So in the pan, you can use milk. Today I'm going to use some half and half. And it is fat free, so we're not racking up the calories tonight.
Half and half?
It's half and half, yeah. So in this gravy, it's going to look really lumpy. You just have to work it and be patient. I'm using a whisk. Some people use potato mashers, whatever you feel comfortable with. So here, and as you can see, the lumps are being removed by just doing this action. So add your milk or your dairy product just a little at a time, and it'll thicken up as you go along. Just keep adding and until you have maybe about a half a handful, maybe not that much, but you'll know about how much to put in. You'll know what's right, because it'll thicken up and it'll reach the consistency of the gravy. So I'm going to let that just sit there a minute, and as it sits there, it'll start to boil. Meanwhile, I'm going to take a look at our meat. Looks really good. Smells good. You smell that meat?
Oh yeah.
It smells good. It
smells like it needs to be eaten.
Okay, and I have that on low. So you see how this thickened up now. And just keep adding just little bits at a time. We're also going to season this gravy, and I'm just going to use the all-purpose seasoned salt, just like we did on the meat. Just a little bit, just to kind of coat it, that way it won't be so bland. And if it's too watery and too thin, what you can do is take a little bit of flour, mix it with water, and just stir it in until it makes a consistency without lumps, you could even pour it through a strainer and just pour it right into your pot. You can see that's pretty thin, but in a minute it'll start to thick up, and then we'll have a gravy again. We'll just add a little bit more milk to that. Now over here I've chopped up some cheese. This is Velveeta cheese, and you can really use any kind of cheese. I like Velveeta because it's thicker and it adds more consistency to your gravy. It's got a really good flavor. So let that thicken up a little bit. I'm also going to add a little bit of pepper to that. About 4 turns of pepper, or a pinch if you're using the already ground. Okay, this gravy is just about done, just about ready to add your cheese. So we're just going to add it in all at once. Before you know it, it'll start melting. But just got to be patient with this because it does take a while. See, we have about a half a pan full of this.
That was the Velveeta cheese?
That was the Velveeta cheese. You can actually use this sauce on a lot of other things. Sometimes when I make breakfast, I pour it over toast and fried egg on top, and that's really good too. You can pour it over your seafood, your shrimp, or your steak to make it have a little bit more flavor. This is going to take just a few minutes, so we'll be in here maybe for about another 5 or 10 minutes. Okay, our sauce is ready. You can see it's a nice thick, but it's not too thick. It's just about the consistency of gravy. So in this sauce, I've got a little bit of salsa that I add, and you can see it's just about 1/8 of a cup. That's just for some extra flavor in there. And to that, I'm also going to add some of this meat. That way, when you pour it on top, it all ties in together. Got our sauce and got our meat in there. Now it's like a thick gravy with bits of meat and some salsa in there. And now we're going to get ready to assemble our smothered burritos. That way you can eat.